Hi everybody, welcome to another exciting stream of OTAG Gaming 14. So today we're going to be jumping back into some more Advance Wars 2 and going from there. So on that note, we're jumping right in. So last we left off, we were halfway through a marathon of a fight. Alright, I forgot. The jazzy theme. Slowly chip away at this thing's health. (Clears throat) Another battleship down. Immediately starting off with a special, jeez Louise.
Sidewinder!
Carry these battle tanks or these battleships. Yeah, they're all just hiding because only one of them can heal at a time.
battle with me. Sidewinder! list.
Sidewinder! It's like I've been at this on this map for probably almost 2 hours collectively at this point. It's likely they're gonna go on for longer. It's like, jeez Louise. It's like I'm trying to get the base, but it's almost impossible. This is kind of tedious.
This is done.
Yeah, it's like if I haven't made any progress in the next 15 minutes, I'm gonna reset the run. Good gosh, this is kind of getting slightly tedious. Pretty much been on a stalemate for goodness knows how long. Part of it is I can't get this factory no matter how hard I try.
battle with Nick. Sidewinder!
Man, I was basically the whole, like, are you done yet kind of thing. Like, I want you to be done. This turn goes on for, like, several minutes. I pretty much can't make planes anymore, which sucks. Thank you. And I was like, can I have my turn yet, please? Yeah, like I said, if I haven't made any progress in 10 minutes, I'm resetting the run, because this is becoming very tedious. Yeah, now this guy takes the factory, we're screwed. I know that, but that specific tank is also killing the run. Even before the battleship showed up, it was really making this incredibly tedious. Yeah, I know some people are gonna have opinions about like which one's the better strategy game, but considering that Fire Emblem is way less tedious in comparison, like way less tedious, I think it's better. Like, it's not even a joke how tedious this gets. Especially when you never have enough money. Yeah, I'm resetting the run. Like, there is no way we're coming back from that. Let's see who they actually recommend for this. Oh, I gotta really reset.
Sir!
Yes.
Yes.
Oh. Alright, see who they recommend for this. Alright, that looks like that's what this guide recommends. Having extreme flashbacks to the final boss of the first game. These are the two people I used for that one. Yeah, like, this is a point where I really wish you could skip the enemy's turn. Like, really wish you could skip their turn. And like the fact that it takes like a half a dozen turns just to set up that end. I just know now to beeline it for that base. Even then, with a battleship, I still might be screwed. Yeah, it's like if this goes south, I might have to very religiously use that guide. Because then it's going to take two turns, given things go ideally, for them to capture it. Yeah, depending on how this goes, I might, like, I'm just casually using the guide just to be like, okay, this, what did you guys do? But if this goes south again, I am religiously using that guide. There's a gig going on that ASAP. Okay, good, that guy's out of range. He's like stalling for time. And I'm just like, just to get endless reinforcements over there. Good gosh. Yep, that's all Max can do that turn. Like, just to stall the plane long enough. Alright, cool. Yeah, I'm not even sure how we even take that airport before we get to it. Hey Joe, welcome in. Just basically doing tap number two of this thing because it got incredibly tedious on the last run. Plus, I was like 2 hours in, so there's also that. It's like, you get your butt over there ASAP. Always comes down to I wish I had more money.
battle with... Sidewinder!
Yeah, I think that's what makes this harder, is the fact that it's special and basically involves him, like, summoning a decent amount of reinforcements. I'm like, ugh. Makes this so tedious. Right now, a bottleneck formed up there. Ugh. I am getting some damage on that thing, or so help me. Thank you.
Delicious. Sidewinder!
Thank you. nothing.
Thank you. Nah, oh, he's blockading that. That's annoying. I mean, there's no way I can kill the darn thing, so I'd say that's another botched run, unfortunately. And I'm only trying it one more time. If I still can't do it, I'm giving up on the game because, and like I said, this is easy mode. It should not be this tedious on easy. Oh, thank goodness he moved. Yeah, now that that thing's in play, that's gonna be really annoying. Great, now the thing's healing.
Delicious.
Yeah, part of this wouldn't even be that bad either if this didn't exist.
Sidewinder!
Which gives him increased attack and gives him more reinforcements. Like, geez Louise. I know, exactly. It's like, yeah, and to put in perspective, Max has yet to get his special, and it's been that long. I know this is basically a game of, is his turn over yet, for the love of everything. And I was like, I gotta get this entire blockade, and that's not even counting the battleships. And this is just a snake around the back somehow. I had to summon a big tank. Why?
Sidewinder!
Gonna get
Max. Oh great, it's blocking the seaport. Just lovely. Thank you. Oh my gosh, the tank is finally dead. Holy crap. The fact that we're being blocked in by battleships is like, good gosh. It only does 8% damage. It's gonna heal next turn, so it doesn't even matter that I do this. honestly surprised they made a map that was somehow more marathon-y than the final boss of the first game. I'm honestly impressed. Like, seriously, the longest Fire Emblem maps wouldn't be more than an hour, and that's the final bosses. This isn't even the final boss of the game. This is, like, several chapters before that, because we haven't even gotten to the Green Country yet. Yeah, it's like every single time you think you make progress, then he pulls his special move and completely wrecks your teams. Let's like start killing some of these guys. Oh, that's being blockaded by a big tank. Ugh. That's disgusting. Just like slowly start chipping away at its health. Very slowly. Yeah, it's like if he captures that seaport, that's gonna be a problem. You know, it's pretty much you pretty much have to insta-kill the battleship, otherwise you're screwed. And I'm just waiting for that bomber at this point. I can't do anything else. My only hope is on the right side, and even that's iffy. Because he keeps sending reinforcements. Just never stops. Like, he's got so many battleships now that it's like it's almost impossible. She just keeps blockading the right side, and it's so annoying. Oh, finally. Well, there goes a battleship. Still barely not enough, are you kidding me? Alright, that gets rid of the submarine.
Delicious.
Sidewinder!
Yeah, like, this is likely going to result in a stalemate in IMDIs that I'm not progressing with the game because I'm like, I have done 2 multi-hour runs of this map. I am not doing it again. Unless someone donates the channel points. That is the only reason I will attempt this again. Because that is 2 to 3 hour runs.
Battle with me. Sidewinder.
And it's like any move I try to make on that side, it's like that the unit ends up being almost insta-kill when it's all said and done. Yeah, I give up. I'm like, yeah, if it's that he is that far into the game, I'm like, I am not playing the rest of it. This game is just getting too boring. Alright. So yeah, kind of as a palate cleanser, I'm going to move on to the game I was going to start tomorrow and just play like the first 50 minutes of it. Like, man, I don't know if I can say I can recommend this series, because good gosh, it's very tedious. Play Fire Emblem instead. Good gosh. Alright, so I'll go swap that out. BRB. Wrong thing. There we go. Time for a palate cleanser for about 50 minutes. So yeah, welcome to the next long play on the channel, which is going to be Dragon Quest XI, one of my favorite RPGs, period, to the point where I cosplayed as the protagonist character, and you'll find out why in the coming, let's be honest, months. Dad, I'm going to get terribly far, but started up. But first, the intro. A little sneak peek at the journey to come, if you will. I know. Thank you. Sorry, I skipped ahead. I'll play it legit next time. Ignore the title screen. Also, ignore that. It just to do the meme. Five. All right. Keeping with tradition. Can't believe this is just a running joke on my channel at this point. Actually, you know, I have a more chaotic idea. I know it's not gonna make any sense, but I don't care. I can spell it right. Welcome on in, Vamp Lad. Time for the cross universes. So yeah, with this game, particularly this port, yeah, you can play it kind of as a classic SNES or NES game like that. Or you can play 3D mode. It's kind of your... I mean, I'm playing 3D mode, but they do give you the option to do 2D. Alright, camera controls. Yeah, lots of settings initially. I forgot about this because it's been years. Opening cutscene.
This child, he is the one?
There's the mark.
No, exactly, just like, too bad. And then things suddenly went to heck. I know exactly.
Oh my. What in heavens are you doing here? And after that awful storm, too. However did you survive? Oh, you're a jolly one. This. Oh, you poor thing. Come here. Come here. Oh, there's no need to be frightened anymore. You're safe now, little fellow.
He adopted a child. Several years later,
thanks so much. You're a lifesaver. Trust me to lose my headscarf just before the big ceremony. So it's finally here, the big day. I can't believe we're going to be climbing all the way up there. Looks like Sandy's keen to lead the way. Come on, best not keep her waiting.
Yeah, a lot of this is going to be relevant later. I was reacquainting myself with this. And there it is in the corner. Welcome, alternate universe Astarion. Symbols on the side of the Tor represent the spirit of the land, you know. The spirits always watched over the people of Cobblestone. The coming-of-age ceremony is one of the ways we show our gratitude for its protection. Yeah, you know how I said there was a, similarities with Octopath Traveler and the fact that Aldrich was from Cobblestone? Off by one letter, and it's also a mountainous city. You know the mayor and your mother are waiting for you to set off the top of the steps, don't you? Don't keep them waiting, dear. Oh, and remember, if you ever need some advice or you stuck for what to do, have a chat with folks with pretty pink speech bubbles above their heads like me. Just press Y and you look at the map. You can't miss us. By looking at the map, use R to change the direction you're facing. It's a handy little trick, trust me. You know, I'm not sure I've ever seen the two of you apart. I think you're all grown up already. Are those wedding bells I hear? Grandma, honestly. Oh, let an old woman have her fun, will you? Now, Astarion, you look after my lovely granddaughter, you hear? So it's time for you to head up to the Tor. Mind you don't slip, it's a long way up. Don't worry, Astarion would never fall. Yeah, I call BS on that. What would you do without him, eh? Well, starting here in the lady, make sure she comes to no harm. The path gets pretty steep up on the tour, so be sure to watch your footing. But don't let you make you stick to the beaten track. Little detours are what's where you find all the fun stuff. I think you and Gemma are all grown up already. Can't remember you little ones having round the place cause causing trouble like this yesterday. Ah, time flies, it really does. And then Sandy's off in the distance. Good luck, Astarion. I wish I was a grown-up like you. Can't wait to climb the Tor. Just look at you, Astarion, my little boy all grown up. Now be sure to look after Gemma, you hear? I think you've been inseparable since you were tiny, and here you are about to climb the Tor together. But if you ever lose your way, just follow Sandy. That dog's got more sense than any of us. to go now, dear. I know the two of you will be just fine. I'll make sure there's a delicious supper waiting for you when you get back. Starring seeing you and my dear Gemma all set for your big day makes me proud as anything, both as a mayor and as a grandfather. You're not kids anymore, you know. No, you're grown up now, and that means going to the tour and offering your thanks. It's time you are on your way. And up to the top, give praise to the spirit of the land that come back down and tells you like the view. But if you're ever unsure what to do next, try pressing X and select Party Talk. Gamma Light has some useful tips for you.
Brilliant!
It's our big day, Astarian. We finally get to do the ceremony. We're going to be grown-ups at last. It's like Sandy's excited as we are. Come on, let's get moving. We don't want her to get to the top before us. At the head will be one steep one, but fear not, my children, for the spirit of the land shall watch over you. May your climb teach you how truly blessed we are to live among such beautiful surroundings. We'll pray for your safe return. Cor, just look at the view. It's beautiful, isn't it? Whenever you find someone with lovely scenery like this, you should take the time to stop and bask in the wonder of nature. It always does me the power of good. Oh, dearie me, where could that boy have gone to this time? I just hope he hasn't decided to go to the tour on his own. No, he wouldn't be that stupid, surely. He'll be the death of me, that one.
Humble folk of Cobblestone, great land spirits, hearth and home. That's how it goes, isn't it? My granddad's been teaching me the prayer ever since I was little. He reckons the spirit of the land really does live on Cobblestone Tor, you see. As long as I can remember, he's been preparing me for this day. The day it would finally be my turn to climb all the way up there and offer my thanks. I just wonder whose idea it was in the first place, sending the village's young folk on such a dangerous errand. What if I take a tumble and do myself a mischief? Well, not to worry. Since you and me were born on the same day, I'm lucky enough to have a bodyguard along for the journey. Come on, then. That craggy old thing won't climb its... Oh!
Oh, no, slimes!
Ah! Monsters! They're coming this way!
You're lucky I know how to wield a sword. Oh, do be careful, you two. Yeah, and then with this game, you can actually, like, as long as you're within the circle, you can move around. And then attempting to leave the circle is basically your way of fleeing. So yeah, you can attack, defend, use items, but currently it's just weapons. Yeah, basically you got your regular sword, which allows you to use a shield in combo, or a great sword. Which you can't use in this battle. Then there's your equipment.
Go on!
And Sandy also gets to fight in this battle.
Crumbs!
The crumbs!
Fight, fight, and fight!
The slimes are defeated. Yeah, medicinal herb, that's basically your healing item for the game.
Crikey, I wasn't expecting that. I know they were only little, but I'd have been done for if you and Sandy hadn't been here to help me. And now we've got to go through that horrible, dingy cave. Just our luck. I'll bet you anything that's where those awful things came from. Well, as long as you're with me, I've got nothing to worry about. Come on, let's get going.
I was gonna say, I'm like, yay, Sandy. Basically, this game's equivalent of Scratch in that sense. Humble folk of Cobblestone, great land, spirits, hearth, and home. Blessed are we since days of yore. Let it be so forevermore. Yeah, this version came out 2 years later, but yeah, I can't believe this game is already 7 years old. It's like, jeez Louise. Welcome to the tour. The Gemma mysteriously vanishes. And then, yeah, like one of the NPCs said, definitely explore around because you never know what you'll find. Yeah, it's one of those, like, the basic battle theme in an RPG is critical because you have to hear it over and over again the entire time, so if it sucks, you're screwed. But luckily, we got a good one. Well, plus, I know people complained about the music in the original version because it was purely synthesized, but in the definitive edition, they changed it to a purely orchestral score. I say this because I saw, a video essay advertised, and they're like, oh yeah, the music sucks, and I'm like, does it? And I'm like, oh, they're talking about the original version. I'm like, no, it doesn't. More monsters, but I don't think they spotted you yet. You should sneak up and try and surprise them. Get close enough and a small orange arrow will appear above them. Press A and give them a weighty wallop with your weapon, lowering their HP before the battle's even begun. Why not try springing a preemptive attack on that slime over there? Yeah, I know exactly. I'm just like, oh, it's such a good soundtrack, because, like, some of it's, like, borrowed from a decent chunk of the previous games, but a decent chunk of it's also original for this game specifically. Get him! Get him! Yeah, and then eventually tactics comes into clutch using, like, change your party as well as doing other things. That's to come. Yeah, eventually you get magic attacks. It's just, yeah, you start out with zero MP, well, plus the protagonist doesn't even start out with magic spells. Just like Astaria, because he doesn't have any spells to start out with. And eventually can have that ability. Although, sorry, no magic missile. Level up! So yeah, basically increases all your stats, so yeah, your health, your magic points, strength, resilience, agility, deftness, magical might, magical mending, and charm. Okay, so level 2 he learns a spell, so which is basically a basic fire spell. No, he can insta-kill the slimes. Yeah, plus whenever you level up all your stats go back to maximum, which is why he has magic points now. Unnecessary medicinal herb. Critical. We seriously should have had you do the 10 sword practice lessons. And then, like Link, you can break pots. Okay, that's just a dead end. Chunk of copper ore. Yeah, occasionally you'll find blue shiny objects on the ground. Always grab those suckers. Get him! The crumbs!
Go on. Gemma,
what the hell's... Get him!
Cool. Look at all this fog. Is this normal, do you think?
Yeah, speaking of that child that wandered
Cole?
Off. When did Cole get here?
Quick! You have to help him!
I mean, do you even have to ask? Time to help Goat Lad in his humanoid form.
It's not fog at all. It's more monsters!
And Sandy takes offense to that. Time to fight the smogs. Keep at it, Astarion. I'll do what I can to help. Singes a single enemy with a small fireball. He's not amused either.
Crikey. Here you go.
Yeah, you should be able to easily take down one of them with the spells. Plus, she'll restore your MP, so you can just keep going at it.
Go on, you can do it. Get him! Well done.
Level up.
I'm sorry, Gemma. I only came up here because I thought it'd be funny to jump out and surprise you. But then those monsters appeared.
What in the world is going on? I never heard anything about monsters appearing on the tour before. But never mind that now. Whatever were you thinking?
It's time to tell you off.
You could have been killed. You take Sandy and get back to the village this instant.
Yes, Gemma. Sorry, Gemma.
You saved my bacon again. I knew you were tough, but crikey, you really have grown into quite the hero.
If only you knew.
Not far to the top now.
Welcome in, Devil Cry. Just gonna be playing this for like 20-ish more minutes, and then we'll get the first session proper going tomorrow.
Come on,
I was basically doing Advanced Wars 2, and then there was one particular map I was on my second 3-hour run, and I'm like, nope, I'm done. Someone could donate the channel points for me to continue playing that game. If you see an exclamation mark icon, move a little closer and press A when it changes to a little arrow in order to interact. It's like, grab the rope. This way to the top. Watch your step. Not much further now. Keep close to the cliffs and don't let your nerves get the better of you. Of course, we're doing it while it's raining, too, because why would it be anything else?
Such a shame about the weather. I was really looking forward to that view. Well, we better say the prayer and get this ceremony over with, eh? What was that?
Sorry, get your butt over there. I will smite thee. Exactly, just like, all right, fine. But I'm only doing this once.
Look, the mark on your hand. Huh? Oh, it stopped. Well, we can worry about that later. All I know is that you saved me yet again. I don't know what I'd do without you. Now, we really had better be finishing up this ceremony. Humble folk of Cobblestone, great land spirits, hearth and home, lift your voices up in prayer, sing it across all our drear. Blessed are we since days of yore, let it be so forevermore.
Magic!
Just goes on and on and on. Whoever dreamed up this ceremony must have had this in mind. They wanted to show us how huge our world really is. Well, that's it. It's all over and now we're grown-ups. Should we head down and tell Grandad and everyone? They'll all be waiting for us at the bottom.
We're not gonna stay more than 2 minutes? Come on.
Oh dear.
Thank you, Astarion. I really thought we were done for there. I don't know what I would have done without you. It's all worrying, isn't it? The monsters, the lightning. We better get that back to Cobblestone. Maybe Granddad knows what's going on. Astarion and Gemma make their way back to the bottom of the Torb. Thank you for bringing Cole back safely, Sandy. Good girl, I knew you could do it. I'm sorry, Gemma. Never thought it'd be funny to jump out and surprise you. I'm an idiot. I'll never do it again, I promise. Mike Hole told me everything. He told me how you fought off those horrible, foggy monsters. I don't know how to thank you. You and Gemma aren't hurt either. Oh, it's such a relief. Well, the main thing is everyone's alright. You can never be too careful with monsters around. Oh, you want Astarion and Gemma and Sandy too. That lightning was terrifying. Are you lot all right up there? Ever so sorry you poor things had to go through such an awful ordeal. So you did it. You've been to the top of the tour. Well, you better let the mayor know. Better be desperate to hear how you got up there. Don't keep him waiting, will you? When the lightning struck the tour, I must confess I fear for your safety, but it seems you escaped unharmed. Truly we must give our thanks to the spirit of the land who watches over us all. Yeah, you're back, you're back. Your mom, said to tell you she's gone home to make your tea. That lightning was so scary. The sky flashed and there was this big bang boom! Well done, you two. So glad to keep you, see you safe. Alright!
We're back safe and sound, Grandad.
Indeed you are, my dear. Thank the spirits for that. When we saw lightning striking up there, we got a little worried, I have to tell you.
Astarion explains what happened on top of Tor.
Well, I never. Sounds like it's nothing short of a miracle that you made it back in one piece. Well, there's no doubt about it. The spirit of the land was watching over you. Now tell me, my dear. How was the view from the top?
Oh, it was wonderful. I saw the sea stretch into the horizon, and the sunlight playing on the water, and... Oh, I've never seen anything like it in my life.
You're true cobblestonians now. Only we have the pleasure of looking out over the world of Erdria in such breathtaking fashion, you know. You're still young. And the day may yet come when you decide to leave Cobblestone behind. I hope our little ceremony has opened your eyes to a little of what may await you out there. Now, it's high time we were heading back. I'm sure your mother is eager to hear how things went, young man. Don't keep poor Amber in suspense.
Come on, you. Home time.
He's like, I can't say no to that. Welcome to Cobblestone. Coming of age, awarded for ascending to the top of Cobblestone Tower and completing the ceremony that signifies the onset of adulthood. So the ceremony's all done. Congratulations. I don't tell me you forgot where you live in all that excitement. Follow the paving stones as you find your way back up. Oh, you must be tired of me forgetting that. You should head home and put your feet up. An intentional roadblock. Yeah, it's like eventually we'll get a key to open those doors, but for now it's a mystery.
Well, not so little anymore. I've heard all about your big adventure. Look at you, all grown up. I hope he wasn't too much of a bother, Gemma dear.
Of course not. Quite the opposite, in fact. You would have been proud of him. We got attacked by a monster at the top of the tower, and I ended up hanging onto the edge of the cliff by my fingertips. I thought I was done for. But you'll never guess what happened next. That mark on his hand suddenly lit up, and a bolt of lightning hit the monster.
What did you say? That funny little mark? Lightning flying about the place? Goodness me. Here I was hoping he'd turn out nice and ordinary, but it seems his grandfather was right all along. Well, I've been putting this off for long enough now. You and me need to have a little talk. Here, this belongs to you. Your grandfather asked me to give you it once you'd come of age and climbed the tower. The truth is, there's something I've been keeping a secret all these years. Something I've never told another soul in the village. It's... how can I put this now? Well, he said you're the reincarnation of the Luminary.
What?
Oh, don't ask me what the old fool meant, dear. I haven't got the foggiest. All I know is that your grandfather said you had a special destiny. And that there was something you had to do. He said that when you came of age, you were to head north to the capital, up there in Heliodor, and show that necklace thingy to the king. He seemed to think that if you did that, all would become clear. Clear as mud, I shouldn't wonder. Anyway, the long and short of it is that if you want to find out what this is all about, you'll have to leave Cobblestone and head over to Heliodor.
Crikey.
Well, I can't stop you leaving, I'm sure, but you won't be marching on an empty stomach. Come on, dinner.
The reincarnation of the Luminary. Starange tries his hardest to sleep, but he's too confused by everything he's learned and excited about his coming trip. Eventually... Having trouble sleeping, are we? Well, it's no surprise after the excitement today, and your big news. Whenever I have trouble nodding off, I like to go for a little walk. The night air always does me a power of good.
Sleep either, eh? You remember this tree, don't you? I got my scarf stuck in it all those years ago. There I was, crying like mad, and there you were, running round trying to help me get it down. Some things never change, eh? You know, I always imagined we'd spend our whole lives right here in Cobblestone. That's why I was so surprised by what your mum said today. All that stuff about you being the Luminary. That reincarnation thing.
Huh.
I remember the story my granddad told me. Once upon a time, long, long ago, the world was terrorized by a horrible monster. But then, the Luminary appeared and saved the day. When it was all over, the Luminary turned into a star. And he's been watching over us from up in the heavens ever since. That's his star, right there. How can you be the Luminary too? I just don't get it. I know. That's what you're going to Heliodor to find out. I understand. Really, I do. Listen, we should both be getting back. Everyone will be wondering where we've got to. Goodbye, old friend.
Saw said after his long day, Astarion finally falls into a restless slumber. Then morning comes.
Well, just look at you. You don't scrub up too bad, you know. Only wish your grandfather were here to see you. You won't forget him, will you? He was a fine, upstanding man, the pride of the village. You could do worse than try to be like him. Well, however you turn out, I'm sure you'll find a way to overcome whatever lies ahead. A mother knows these things. Oh, by the way, I've popped a little money I'd saved for a rainy day in your pack. Don't spend it all at once. Why don't you visit the village shop before you head off to Heliodor? You'll need some supplies for your big adventure. But don't take too long. The whole village is turning out to wave you off.
Yeah, like, definitely do what you need to do beforehand, because once you leave this area, you're not going to be coming back here for a while. You're setting out into the world, my child. Perhaps a little prayer before you depart. So yeah, this is basically how you save your game, either finding them or holy statues. Confess to me all you've done, child, so that I might record it in an adventure log. Yeah, and plus they can do other things. Learn how much experience each party member needs to reach the next level, bring fallen party members back to life, cure any poisoned party members, remove curses, and then switch to 2D mode. Alright, on that note, I will save the coming journey for tomorrow. Alright, so thanks for tuning into the stream. I was able to get some, basically wrap up Advance Wars 2 and then start that game up. And like I said, we'll continue that tomorrow. That's about it. Let's even go raid. Okay, what the heck is this game? I'm gonna go raid John. I mean, like, you can't just have a title like Pepper Grinder not mean to have me not be curious. Alright, there we go. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you guys later in the week. Take care.